They do a lot of great things to help us out around here. I'd like to remind everybody to turn off their phones and not to check text messages during the performance. It can be very distracting. Yeah, it's just kind of rude. So, I would also like to let you know that this is a melodrama. And in this melodrama, we ask for you guys to help us out on stage a little bit. So in the classic idea of melodramas, the audience has no problem letting us know what they think. But, so for example, if the dastardly villain came out, you all might want to
boo!
Or if the wonderful, all wonderful lady comes and she's delightful, you might want to
boo!
I'm sorry, I thought you were gonna close, so I better go. Right, and so you can follow along with these signs throughout the performance. And there's going to be one short intermission. And with that, I hope you enjoy the show.
Y'all misspelled
Yoo-hoo! Glory be! Where'd you come from?
The stage, Cody. I expect the song to greet us, but this town seems completely deserted.
This is Los Pueblos, isn't it?
It certainly is. Who's you expecting to meet you?
Mr. Hezekiah Jones. May.
Ooh la la!
Liza, come again, Beth.
Are you sure you're good looking in your school teacher, prospective bride? Well, if that magnificent creature would even consider marrying me, why would they down and die a half man right now?
Excuse me. It seems we've been on the wrong trip.
show. I believe you mean my Wild West show.
Yeah. One time you went at poker.
We went up south with the only Wild West show that's never been west of the Mississippi before.
Well, till now it is.
I still think that poker game was fixed.
And under your 5 management, we shot straight from Puerto Rico. And on top of everything else, we're stranded out here in California.
Right. Ain't no one gonna pay to see a Wild West show out here.
Which is exactly what we need to get ourselves some work in. Then you can get some real jobs and buy our contract off this idiot so that can be free.
You want to be free? Please, take it. I don't want you. I'm an actor, not an agent. You've been a thorn in my side ever since I acquired your pathetic act. I should have insisted Harry pay me the money he owed me, but no. I let him talk me into one hand of winner take all, double or nothing poker. And since he had no money, I got you.
Oh, man, I don't know that. He really tricked you.
The Muldoons ain't taking no charity from you, Mr. Great Actor. We'll get us some more rent, and we'll get us some jobs, and we'll pay you off fair and square for that contract.
Aw, Hannah, not that word.
Jess, you ought to have some learning.
Aw, Hannah, we don't need no word. We're gonna get by just fine. We use our wits to our fists.
Wits? Wits? Just eat Moon Muldoon. When the Almighty said it was, he thought he was serving grits, and he said, I ain't never had much experience.
Now listen here, Hannah. If Bone is so dumb, how come he can shoot so good, huh? That's gonna be fast.
Why are you Bone at? Hannah ain't said this about my smart.
That's right, Bone. You got nothing to speak of.
All right, now listen. I gotta send this mess and I'll get us out. But Jess is right about one thing. No one in California is gonna pay to see a Wild West show.
Why?
Folks out here can all shoot, rope, and ride.
Ain't nobody east or west is better than me.
Point is, the frontiersmen, shooting and riding wasn't entertainment. It was survival. But I'm sure they'd gladly pay to see some Shakespeare.
Excuse me. Okay, I thought I'd tell you something. I'm not playing Juliet again!
Come on now. If a fellow playing Juliet was good enough for the Elizabethans, surely he'll be good enough for the Californians.
No. What? Last time some fell from the audience and flowers and can't. Yeah, come on, keep laughing. Yeah, let's have a little laughing party. He's having flowers and candy, he wanted to keep us to the ranch.
From what I heard, it was a mighty fine ranch.
Yeah, and that candy weren't too bad neither.
Still, if you insist on doing Shakespeare, just have my good friend Hannah play the part of Juliet. Then she's a real girl.
Leo, you play a much more convincing Juliet than she would. Hannah Muldoon would murder the King's English.
I ain't good for no English, but I might just bloody a certain upbeat, self-righteous high string. No talent, cries his vernacular.
No talent? No talent? Why? The part's never been written, a character never created that I can't play. Name a character, any character, I'll play the part so well, I'll pull the next person to walk through that door.
Come on, Teddy. You walked 2 days just to get to the small town. You don't know you're good.
Well, I don't know you're good. You can prove it to me. But I ain't interested in the 5 minute show.
You gotta fool them all day.
I bet you and Nicole, you can't be good.
No problem. Who would you like me to play? A hero? A lover? A scoundrel?
All of them.
What?
First, play the hero. Oh, I know, a U.S. Marshal. You got a badge and gun in that bag of tricks of yours?
I'll check.
Then a lover. And last, a villain so cool, the Meg, Jesse James, I Billy the Kid, and Johnny Dillon, Shake Your Boots. If you can play those 3 parts, bing, bang, boom, and keep believing you're that character all day, then I might agree that you're a halfway decent actor.
But I don't think you can do it.
I can do it.
Okay.
But remember, you gotta fool whoever walks through that door before you lose.
And that
was bad. Prepare to be amazed.
Folks, this is Bates, U.S. Marshal. I just pulled into town for a routine
The people up at the head office heard that my business trouble brewing out this way, so they sent me down to make sure everything was all right.
It's to get trained to know that Bus Book is under the protection of a United States Marshal.
Speaking as interim sheriff, I can second that.
I'll bring it up with you, Marshal Best.
Thank you, miss. Just doing my job. If I had known you was here, I would have dropped by a lot sooner.
I've only just arrived, Marshal, but thank you for saying so.
Shucks, miss.
Excuse me, Marshal, can I sit over here?
Pardon me?
Of course.
You're supposed to be playing a lawman and a lover boy.
I thought you wanted me to play the wolf.
Well, not at the same time.
You can romance next girl to come in.
Susan, I was flat outside. I'm just here to make sure everything's all right.
Providence must have sent you, Marshal. That outlaw family, the Wilders, have been spotted in the area.
Oh dear, I hope we don't get bothered by scoundrels.
Never fear, dear lady. Marshal Bass is on the job. They'll steer clear of this town if they know it's good for them.
Your presence is a great comfort, Marshal.
Lisa, dear, I'm exhausted. You go on and take a look at the school house while I take a nap. Of course, we'll need to get a room first.
You'll find a good practice upstairs.
Thank you, Marshal.
I'll walk you a bit, Beth. I'll only be a moment, gentlemen.
Allow me to escort you.
We'd be delighted.
I'll take that.
Hey!
cute. A bit scrawny, but I'm sure that can wait up. What do you say, you and I go find some hay?
That sounds really inviting, but I'm afraid I can't. Perhaps you and your friends would like to come back here tonight at 7 and...
Good idea. We'll have a wedding. Right here. Auburn Creature.
Wedding?
You're one fast worker, Mr. Romulo.
Lieutenant James Dash. Miss? back more to town. I've sure missed the theater since being stationed in the West.
What a shame. What a crying shame, eh, Teddy?
Tragic. Perhaps you'd like to come to our performance tonight at 7, right here in Molly's lobby. A performance of Shakespeare for only a nickel.
See the bar's own words before?
No, Lieutenant, darling.
Dash.
No argument here. Oh, we're looking at Shakespeare stuff, not the bars.
Oh, my dear, what's your name?
Hannah,
will do. Hannah, it's nice to meet a young lady who's both talented and has a sense of humor. I can't wait to see you perform. What role are you playing?
Well?
Yes, Hannah, what role would you like to play? That's such a vast repertoire.
What?
You have a large compendium of...
Hey! My compendium ain't larger than it ought to be!
Oh, Hannah, you are in line. Please reserve me a seat in the front row.
Perhaps you'd like to invite some of your fellow officers to attend the performance tonight as well.
I'm afraid that ain't possible. Four bucks to today's raffle here, and I'm only hearing our reaching check in the surrounding towns. I've come here because I heard that the Wilder Bunch is around here. The Wilder Bunch is here, and that means that Johnny Dillon ain't far behind.
I think you're really going to want to hear that. Why would that be, Lieutenant?
Well, don't you know? Johnny Dillon is head over heels in love with Crazy Kate Wilder.
He is?
Chris Kate will have nothing to do with Johnny Dillon, but he follows her around anyway. Eventually, Chris Kate's gonna have to marry Johnny Dillon.
How come?
Every time Chris Kate shows his last bit interest in a guy, Johnny Dillon shows up at their wedding and kills him. Eventually, there won't be anyone left.
How come you didn't tell me?
Try it.
Now, if y'all excuse me, I need to find Mayor Jones.
Oh, gee, Teddy, looks like we're in big trouble here.
Okay, let's not panic. Lieutenant said he'd be here, and it's his job to protect us, right?
He's
too
pretty. I don't know, he's on checkup.
Oh, Lieutenant, you're such a fine man. Too bad I never been here.
Aw, shucks, mister. I mean, ma'am. I can't wait to see you perform a little Shakespeare. What role are you playing?
You two bucktooth hound dogs better hightail it out of here, for I forget I'm a lady and you're still a bloody bull.
Hold it. We gotta talk. All right, Charlize. Why didn't you warn me about Kate and Johnny? And why'd you tell the lieutenant we were performing Shakespeare? I don't have time to teach you the part by tonight.
You don't have to teach me the part.
I've seen you and Leo do it
3-4 times now. I can do it in my sleep. Anyway, Lee should not be playing the girl's part.
In the Elizabethan era, all the roles were played by men. And since you're playing a girl, try to look like one.
Why, you!
And maybe try to act like one, too. Especially since you're taking a fancy to that lieutenant.
Why, you know that Leo's silent, and I'll show you just keep wait!
Leo, make sure she knows her lines.
Wait, where are you going?
I'm going to go find Miss Hastings and offer her the protection of a U.S. Marshal. Ta-ta!
I hate that man!
Well, who can act as well as you should?
What? Why?
Because you have to make this entire small town of Lockport, California, believe that you and him are badly in love. Come on, jump up.